Okay, everyone knows as soon as I start filming, the wind starts blowing. I think it's the wind gods just showing me that they want me to get people complaining about it's windy out. I guess I could maybe try to put it in the shade a little bit, see if it blocks the wind. I don't know if that's better or worse. Then you can't hear me. Alright, so I picked up some warmer, and Buddy just pushed that little horse out of the shed again, and it kind of irritated me because he wasn't doing anything. So I'm gonna tie Mr. T, or not Buddy, Mr. T, poor Mr. T. I'm gonna tie Buddy and Ransom up together and see if we can't work some of these issues out. So let me grab Buddy. Buddy's gonna have to go that way. Good. He got cleaned up. So I'm gonna spray him down with some fly spray. The other day somebody goes, why don't you put fly spray on a rag and rub it on him? Okay, whoever said that comment, that's not thinking very good. I don't want my horse to have a rag. I want him to accept the fly spray. So I don't want to make it easy and try to help the horse because he won't fit. No, he's going to learn how to accept fly spray. So I'm going to go with fly spray, and they're going to get fly spray. Buddy, you're going to get caught up on that rope again because you want to try and go people. Why don't you back up a little bit, boy? Back up. There, stand over there and be a good boy. No pushing or bite or beer pinning, or you're going to get a big spanking. Needs to learn to accept things that he don't necessarily like. So he doesn't like the fly spray. I'm not going to stop doing the fly spray. I'm going to do the fly spray more. I might even get a spray bottle of water and spray him down with water 4 times a day till he learns to stop doing this. Now, he's going to work it out, so I don't have to go that far. But if you've got a horse that you've taught, every time he says no, you change what you do and do something else, then you may have to get a spray bottle of water. He's going to learn to accept, even though he doesn't like it, fly spray. Because I'm not going to be worried about getting a rag and, oh, he doesn't like it, so I won't do it. Now, normally, he won't let me spray him like that. He backs away like this, gives me those ears, and he's not on the lead rope. He knows he's tied up, so he's not really messing with me.
I know.
Buddy don't care because I think he's figured out after he puts this crap on me, I don't love him much.
this stupid human likes to spray me with things. That's probably more the case. And remember, male didn't like fly spray either. So, tip one, if your horse doesn't like something, you do it more. If your horse doesn't like to tie, he gets tied more. If he doesn't like to have a saddle on, he gets a saddle on more. If he doesn't like to pick up his feet, he gets his feet picked up more. It's all, I got that fly spray on my hand, so what I usually do is just rub it on their head. I know you don't like it. Tough luck. Tough luck, mister. You're in big trouble if you pin your ears and start a fight. Now you notice, these two can't stand as close in that damn stall because Buddy wants to pin his ears and kick him off. Now, maybe when I was doing something, Buddy pinned his ears at him and I didn't see it. But he accepted a fly spray. That's good. This morning, I was laying out hay and Buddy came over and pushed him off. And I was just like, you know what? I've had enough of this crap. I made one pile. I pushed Buddy off and I stood there. And I didn't have my camera with me, so I couldn't film it. But I'll try to film it like tomorrow or next time I give him hay. And guess what? No fighting when I was there. Rick, that rope's too long. He's going to step on it. You know what? I'm going to go get a rope right now. And somebody asked me, how do you teach him not to be afraid of ropes? Well, I'm about to go show you. So his rope is long. And I've also got the wormer over there. So I'm going to worm them both. And I don't know if he... Look, he's still eating his little... He's going back for seconds on his little food there. He likes to eat it when I first laid out. And then later he comes back after it sits outside for a while. So when I turned my back, Buddy was sniffing his nose. So I want these two to kind of be in each other's face. I want them to get used to being. I want Ransom. Here's my theory. And I figured this out this morning when I was feeding them. And it's just a theory, people. So don't come here. You don't know what you're talking about. This is what's going on. Shut up, freaking crybabies. Okay, I discuss my theory and what I think and what I've learned, and then you get to decide on whether or not it's BS or not, and you get to follow it or not follow it. It's really simple. You don't have to come here and try to be a right fighter. But anyway, so here's what I think is going on here. We got two issues. One, Buddy's never been the lead horse. He doesn't know how to be a leader. He's always had Mr. T the leader. He knows how to push a horse, but he doesn't necessarily know how to make sure that his herd is cohesive. Remember, I told you, Mr. T, if he had a horse acting up, he would run him out of the herd and make him stand out until he came back in and act respectful. Mr. T didn't want his herd always fighting and jumping around and worried about each other. He wanted them to exist, coexist, be able to look for predators, and it's good for the herd. He doesn't want somebody in there being a pest, kind of like what Buddy is doing to this guy. Now, I realize, and there's always those people that come here, they're just being horses. You're trying to humanize it, and you just need to leave it. Shut up. Do your horse shit the way you want. And again, on the other one, I told people, I don't need your damn advice. Look, I don't mind suggestions, and I don't mind input, and I don't mind you sharing things that you've experienced, and it may work or whatever. Those are fine. I'm not talking to you people. I'm talking about the people that come here just to be rude and a smart ass and to make some, you don't know what you're doing. You should have done this. You're stupid. You know, those are the people that I'm complaining about. But anyway, and then I have the people coming afterwards. Just ignore them. And they don't, of course, they don't have to read, you know, 1,000 comments a day. And they don't have, you know, 2,000 or 3,000 videos on YouTube and has to listen to all this. So it's easy for them to come up with this great solution of, you just need to ignore them and just concentrate on, shut up, freaking, I'll ignore what the hell I want. I ignore you, how about that? Anyway, okay, Moki came out. Hi, Moki Moke, say hi to YouTubies. Like, what's up, YouTube peeps? All right, so here's my theory on two things going on. Buddy's never been a leader, so therefore, he doesn't know how to do that. And Ransom doesn't know how to be with a herd because he's been alone for so long. He's been alone for what? I mean, he's got to be... I've seen him since I moved here, standing in that same pasture, and I've been here for 8 years. So I don't know how long before that. So he's been alone a long time without horses. When I said he was with cows, cows were next to him. You know, people talked about Romeo across the street. Romeo is kind of mixed in with the cows, and he runs with the herd. So it's a little different. The sprinklers just kicked on. If you saw their heads go up, these sprinklers over here for my septic system just kicked on, and they like heard that ch-ch-ch-ch, and they went, hey, what's that? Even though they've heard it 1,000 times, they still look at it like, uh-oh, is that friend or foe? So You notice Buddy's a little short right now. I'm going to lengthen him up a little bit. I wanted to see if I had to correct him and tell him, and I wanted to make sure that Ransom had enough rope to get away if he tried to bully or be mean or exert her dominance, whatever you want to call it. So I wanted Buddy short, and I wanted Ransom to be able to get away. And so that's why their system like that is the way it is. So the two things going on, I'll get back to that. I know I'm flipping around. Let me move this past the somebody's hand. What's that thing spinning? It was in Buddy's head. It's a wind thing, and it doesn't work. I need to take it down because I got to get a new one. But anyway, so the two things going on, Buddy hasn't been in a herd by himself where he's the leader. So he doesn't understand that. He's got a herd of one. So he's like focusing all his attention on this guy, showing him who's boss. Kind of like a lot of people do with their freaking horse. They got one horse. They don't understand the concept of, you know, Mr. T would never push and harass and continue to, as soon as you showed him respect, he was good. And if he thought you weren't showing respect, he would correct you once and move on and be over. But he's like correcting almost every time there's any perceived, not immediate yield. And, so I don't want him to think that that's normal. So I want to break that pattern. And I know a lot of people are, you should let him work it out. And some horses just don't get along. And when you get involved, you tell us not to get involved. Now you're getting, shut up, you freaking idiots. I'm telling you, every situation is different. Totality of circumstances. You have to do what works best for you. I'm doing what I think is best. So this morning when I went out there and fed them in one pile, there was absolutely no pinning or anything. Once I corrected Buddy once, I ran him off once. I let them come back, and they were eating literally nose to nose in the grass like Mr. T and him used to do. And there was no problem. The only problem was I had to stand there. If I left, Buddy would pin his ears and Ransom would move away. So I had to stay there to create my leadership position that when I'm here, there ain't no fighting. And you guys need to get along. And they got along. And this is another thing I'm kind of doing here. I'm tying them up saying you guys need to get along. I mean, when you're out in pasture, if you want to push each other and run and fight and do all that, you can. But you need to get along. Now, they're getting along pretty good. And you know, for being together for, I think I brought him over Monday. I think I posted a video like Tuesday. So today is, I think it's Tuesday. Let me check. It is Tuesday today. So if I brought him over Monday, they have been together for 7-8 days now. This is the 8th day they've been together. Now, some people will say, man, it's going fast, it's going fine. This ain't going fast enough for me, because I'm like, I need to get shit done. I want these guys over this freaking BS. So, some people would say if I left it alone, it might correct itself in a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, a month. If I let it go for a month, it may become normal. Then it becomes habit, and then Buddy learns that pinning the ears and everything has become so normal, and I've done it for so long that it's acceptable, and I don't want him learning that. So, when I feed them, they're going to get fed in one pile, and I'm going to have to stand by the pile and make sure there's no fighting, no challenging, and I'm going to tie them together more, and I'm going to make them spend time standing there together. So right now I need to worm them, and I need to go get a rope and work on making sure Ransom knows how to get out of trouble. Now I already know Buddy knows how to get out of trouble because I've hobble trained him and I've done all this. I haven't done any of that with Ransom, so I don't know how much he knows or how good he is. A couple people made the comment that he looks like he's putting on weight. I don't know if he's putting on weight, but he's definitely putting on muscle. I used to pet his back end, and it was completely flab. There was no muscle, no hardness whatsoever. And now when I feel him, it's firming up. So because he's putting on muscle, he's probably putting on weight, but I can definitely feel that he's putting on muscle. So that's a good thing because he's moving around. I haven't really seen him run or trot a lot, so I'm not real sure about whether the trimming helped. I called 3 freaking farriers yesterday, and not one of them returned my call. So, I mean, trying to get a farrier is just, all I wanted to do, that's the first time he's kind of sniffed. Buddy's been kind of, you know, he's kind of nervous to get by Buddy. And so when I was in the stall and when I was feeding him, he was able to sniff Buddy and kind of say, hey, can we get along? I see Buddy's kind of like, hey, dude, I'm not sure about this. I don't know if you see Buddy's ears. Of course, Buddy had to move behind the thing again. His contract is to irritate me when I'm filming. So he kind of gave him a little bit of ears, but again, I'm going to make them get along. And if they... What are you doing, little Bale? Are your boys out of sight? They're okay. I got her a warmer. I got three warmers, so I'm gonna give her a warmer. I'm gonna worm both. Okay, so people may say, why are you worming? That's poison, you shouldn't do that. All right, here's my theory. Normally, I don't like worming. I don't like getting them on a big regimen. But I've got two new horses that I have no idea where they come from, and because of the looking at their feet and looking at other possible neglect issues, or maybe not neglect, maybe just non-care that I would give, that's an indicator that they probably aren't wormed. If somebody isn't taking care of their feet, they're probably not worming them, they're probably not doing their teeth, they're probably not grooming them, they're probably not doing a lot of things. And again, Rick, you shouldn't judge because you don't know, and maybe, whatever. Be quiet, freaking idiots. So I want to worm all the horses to know at least, I know at least they got one worming. And now I can look at their poop for the next few days and see if I find dead worms in it, and then I'll know. I asked my vet about that diatomaceous earth. And he said, that's an old farmer thing. He goes, it does not prevent worms. He goes, people that use that, their horses have worms. He goes, there's also worms that get inside the skin or muscle or, he didn't mention thread worms, but I think he was kind of talking like thread worms, because I suppose they get in the neck. And when you put them on that ivermectin, that gets into their system, and it's supposed to force the worms out. Even if it doesn't kill them, it puts them in the body to where the body can get rid of them. And the diatomaceous earth, and I know everybody's going to be putting the phonetic pronunciation, which a lot of people did, but you know what? Whatever. D-E. He says that shit. He goes, I'm not sure if giving them that and having them possible breathe it in and get lung issues isn't more of a hazard than not doing it at all. And he's a pretty level-headed guy. I mean, I don't dislike worshiping because he's a vet. We've talked about several things, and there's very few things that I kind of disagree with him on. And he owns horses. So, buddy, you be good. You guys can kiss. No biting or pinning. Buddy, beat you like a red-headed stepchild, boy. So somebody sent me that red halter for Buddy, and I haven't used it. And that's not a pink rope. People are like, you got a pink rope. That's red, people. That's as red as can be. Maybe after the sun fades it, it'll be pink. But it's red. But anyway, I don't really care. Some people just love to pick on me for pink. Other people just want to be naggy. So, I'm going to, I don't know if he's ever been wormed, how he's been wormed. You'll be able to see me worm him. And then I'm going to get a rope. Maybe I'll get a rope first. I'll stress him out a little bit before I give him the warmer. So let me go find a rope to beat Buddy with, because he's being mean and he's going to get his butt beat. Buddy's a bad horsey. He's a bad horsey. I'm around the corner. I can't see you. But if you beat that horse, I'll know it. So don't even try to do it because I'm around the corner, boy. So, Buddy's been there and done this, so he really don't care. And Ransom, somebody said, Ransom doesn't seem like he bothers, he's not worried about the camera. Yeah, he's not worried about it yet, because he hasn't figured out. Every time I pull his camera out and start talking, shit starts happening. As soon as he figures that out, he ain't gonna like the camera much. So, I've got a little rope here. This is just one of the, what I call the crappy ropes, the cheap nylon ropes that people buy, and it burns the shit out of your hands when you rub it. I put a little bit of whipping. Let me turn this around so I can see what the hell I'm doing. I put a little bit of whipping on it so the ends will stop fraying, and now it has a little thing so when I beat the horse it won't hurt. I'm not beating a horse with a rope, people. So I'm going to go put this and tie up this horse. And hopefully they're in camera. And I tried to order a wireless mic. To see if it'll work, because I don't have a mic port, but I have a mini USB 5 pin, and they have a 5 pin mini USB to USB, and the mic I ordered takes a USB. So I'm going to see if I can get a lapel mic that works at a distance. So
Buddy, I'm gonna beat you like a red. I saw you, boy. You're in big stinking trouble. I saw you bite that horse in the neck. Now, I'm glad Ransom didn't react to that. And if I had something in my hand that I could hit Buddy in the head with when he did it, I would have.
Rick, you shouldn't throw things at your horse. You're gonna make him scared.
Shut up. Horse needs to know. Hi, Belle. A horse needs to know that you can reach out and touch them. When you teach a horse, the only time you can touch them is when you're close. They learn that distance that they can be when they don't have to listen. I gave that dog story to where there's a certain point when we send a dog out for a bite. As long as they know that you're close enough to where you can get the leash, they'll come back. But once they get past a certain point, they're going to bite that guy and you're not getting them back. So we had to work on that when we were training dogs. And we used to call it a threshold. What is their threshold where they listen? Buddy.
You're in big trouble.
So, you have to learn a threshold on where your horses listen. And if they don't listen to a threshold, you got to teach them that you can still reach out and touch them. So I don't have a problem picking up a rock, a piece of poop, a stick, and just throw it at them and let them know I can touch you at a distance. But when I say no, I want them stopping what they're doing and looking at me. Somebody made a comment, but he didn't go out the gate the other day when you said no. Well, yeah, because he knows when I say no, something's going to happen if he keeps doing what he's doing. All right. So let me go mess with Ransom's feet and see how he does. So first, we'll see if he's cinchy at all by doing this rope and tightening that up and spinning it. And he feels the rope rubbing and pulling. His ears are back. I'm not giving a big deal. I'm going to slowly move back to the flank. I'm going to stand over here in case he does kick when I get back to the flank area. But I want to watch his head. He's like, dude, what the hell are you doing? Okay, so he did pretty good. Now, somebody's going to say, he's had professional training. No, maybe I did it in a way not to cause him to act like he had no training. Maybe that's why he did good. See, people, you need to give yourself credit. When your horse does good, you're doing good. Instead of saying, oh, my horse did good because I sent him to a professional. If you're not doing good, I don't care how many professionals you sent him to. It ain't going to work. So he did pretty good with that one. I'm going to bounce it around him a little bit. Buddy's probably going to grab it and say, hey, dude, you want to play? Put it on his ear and his head and see how that works. And he's doing pretty good. Okay, so I'm okay with that. Does that help him know that if he steps on his rope, he's not going to get caught? No. But what it does, too, is it tells me where his mind's at before I go down to tying his leg up, that he knows where the rope is. He's not showing anything here. Now we're going to move down to feet and see if he's been trapped or taught how to give up room. So I'm going to put a little slip knot on this. Just did a little overhand knot, and then I'm going to put this through here so I can wrap it around his leg, and then I'm going to slide this on his leg like so. Okay, so you know what's going on. And again, I'm watching to see what kind of reaction I'm getting. Does he care that this is on his leg and I'm tugging and pulling? Is it making him nervous? He's about to poop, so it may be making him a little nervous. All right. Let me go get the poop cleaner. Buddy, don't make him move into that poop. I'm gonna beat you, boy. Let me get that out of there before you start messing around with him. So I've touched his leg with it. And we'll just fertilize this tree a little bit. Alright. Woo! That smells strong, doesn't it, buddy? Woo! That's a strong little poopy. I always clean up poop because I don't like my horses getting used to standing or walking in poop. It's not good for their feet. Not horrible. It's horse poop isn't bad in their feet, but I just don't want them getting used to it. So I laid that rope down on his ankle. Now, for the people that were saying he doesn't care about this rope, I'm going to say I disagree because he pooped. And when you put stress on a horse, trail load, or anything, a lot of times they'll poop. So maybe he just needed a poop, or maybe this was stressing him a little bit and he wasn't showing it in his resistance, but his internal said, I'm going to poop because I'm too nervous. So I'm tapping this around his foot. I'm getting him used to something being tied to his foot, moving around. Now I'm going to pull on it and yank on it. Now I'm going to see if I can pick it up. Now I'm going to hold it up. He's like, okay, I got it. He trapped my foot. I got it. I'm going to let it back down. And I did pretty good. So, for the first foot, I'm pretty good with that. Now somebody's going to say, that poor horse, somebody tied his foot up before, that's why. Look, if you introduce things slowly, most horses are going to take it. If you don't get too focused on it and make it all about this rope and, oh my God, he moved, I better stop. Oh, I don't want to pull too hard. Don't, it's okay, baby. Don't, it's okay, it's okay. So now Buddy's pooping. We got a poop fest here. And both their poops look the same damn color. You guys must be eating the same thing. You guys must be eating the same stuff, my buddy. Okay. So I'm going to move Buddy. Because he wants to get over here for some reason, and that ain't going to happen. So I'm tying up this tree. Come here, corn chip. So now, the reason I don't like tying him there when it's muddy, because he's going to walk off the mat. But at least he can go eat and keep occupied and stay the hell out of my business. Now, of course, this doesn't help them tie close together. Now look at him with his leg up. That was almost like a frustration. He held that other leg up. I don't know if he was stretching or had a cramp. Did y'all see that? His left leg was completely bent like I did with his right leg. Someone else asked about his yawning. Is that a sleep disorder? Is he not getting enough sleep? Is he in pain? You know, it could be any of those. I don't know. Maybe he's not sleeping. Maybe, you know, when it rains like this, they don't lay down in the water too much. So maybe they're not laying down. Maybe he does have a jaw. Maybe he's getting food or grass trapped in there. If you want to know if your horse has abscess, somebody says maybe he's got an abscess. If you want to know if your horse has an abscess, smell his breath. Just when he opens up like that, smell his breath. So I'm going to smell his breath, but he's going to get warmer in a minute, so it's not going to taste good at all. All right, so let me go work his other leg. Maybe I'll move this to the other side. Since these guys are starting to look at the pasture because they want to go back out the pasture, like, damn, this is boring. We thought we were going to get food. This shit ain't working out like it was planned. All right, so let me move the pooper scooper so nobody steps on it and breaks it, and I'll be irritated. Hi, buddy boy. So they both pooped, they both got the little nervousness out of it. Again, I want to see how he reacts to rope everywhere that a rope might get caught on him, and does he react and panic? Has he never had a rope on him? He may have never had a rope and he just accepts things easy. I don't know. He's a pretty good little mellow horse. A little bit of tenseness here. That's why I didn't want you over there. See, I can't do shit with Buddy. Because it just, no matter what it is, he's going to start tearing up something. I told you he'd walk in the mud, and he's going to walk over here and make big holes and divots. Get over here. Thank you.
It's okay.
It's okay. I know.
All right. So, I'm okay with the front legs. Now I'm going to do the back legs. He just saw the donkeys walking by.
So I got Buddy tied short now, and I normally don't like tie him short because he sits there and pulls and yanks and pops his head. But otherwise, he's going to dig a damn hole to freaking shine over there if I don't. Because, so I'm gonna try on Ransom's back legs now and see what he does.
Back legs are a little bit more iffy because if he kicks or does something, you're kind of in the kick zone. He's feeling pressure. I'm going to see if he'll let me lift it up. Pressure. No give. Pressure. Gave a little bit. Now I'm going to go for the pickup. Pressure until he picks it up. Good boy. Good boy. There you go. So that's not too bad. If he had arthritis or pain there, could that have caused a more reaction? Could have. He might have reacted, and it may not because of the rope. It could have been because of pain. So that's something else you need to look at. You're okay. You don't have to move, bud. We're going to pick up this leg. Get him used to something calling his leg a rope. Pull. Pull. And pull. He picked it up. Held it. And we're going to let down. Good boy. All right, so now, what did I just hear crying? Is that like a dog? Hang on. Can I hear a dog crying? I thought I heard a little dog yapping. I know they got a new puppy over there, so I don't know if it got out. I don't want him getting by that donkey because he might stomp him. Come here, buddy. Not you, Bill. Not you, buddy. I was talking to the dog, and you guys need to know who I'm talking to. Look at Buddy. He's got freaking flowers growing out of his feet because he tore up all my grass. So see, you can't chase the flies away because I had to tie you short, and you don't listen. So now you can't even get the flies off you. See? That's what happens. Good little Ransom. I know. It's not a carrot. It's my phone. He felt something in my pocket. All right. So that's just an initial kind of making see how his legs is. See how he is with a rope. See if I can get a reaction. Again, I'm always trying new things with new horses to see what might get a reaction with him. Now, obviously, I would want to hobble train him, put a set of hobbles on him. I've got a video where I was hobbling Buddy and Mr. T. Buddy runs off with him, but Mr. T stood still like he should, like a good warrior, take little steps. So let me get the warmer and we'll get on the warmer. Most wormers are wormers. I usually do the wormers with the ivermectin. That's kind of like my go-to medicine. This brand, it puts in, most ivermectin has 1.87% of ivermectin. So that's usually what you're looking for. If you get something lower, then it's not going to be as strong. This puts some other chemicals in here with it. I use Equimax for a while. They're a little bit more pricey. I think these are like $15.50 each. And I got three of them, one for Bill and one for these two. So the thing about wormers are some of them are apple flavored. I don't think it really matters to me. They've never been that receptive to an apple or non-apple flavor. It usually comes in a tube with the amount of weight